Hello everyone, this is me, Sadhya, here, and I'm doing your third week of July reading, start from the 15th through the 21st of July 2021. This reading is going to be for the sign of Sagittarius, so let's see what is coming up for you guys for this week time. I will be adding oracle cards in this reading, but no charms will be added, so stay tuned. And while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you, it's a general reading, even if it may not resonate with everyone out there, so always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal needs, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily reads. So yeah, let's see, Sagittarians, what can you expect coming up for you for this week time? Somebody's gonna feel prepared for love, be that you or your person. I do see somebody's gonna feel like, you know, stop controlling their emotions and give into a connection. It can be you, it can be them. Let's see more messages. Let's see what else can you expect coming up for you, Sagittarians, for this week time, starting today. Eight of Pentacles, Page of Pentacles, the Tower. You might be, hold on, Three of Cups, the Wheel of Fortune, Ten of Cups. You might be reaching out to a specific someone, Sagittarius. The energy could be reversed for some of you, so just be mindful of that as well. But I feel like, you know, yeah, definitely thinking to pursue. Or maybe it's energy of a person that you're dealing with. Let's see more cards first. Okay. Okay. Wow. Somebody's feeling ready and prepared to take a connection to the next level. Now, it can be you, it can be them. It seems like, you know, somebody who was running away from facing their love emotions is the one who's going to making this, you know, effort to take this connection to the next level. I feel like, you know, it's that time when... it seems like, you know, somebody's preparing themselves. Maybe they are, you know, preparing themselves in terms of how they want to propose you. You know, it can be them. It can be them, and you could be on the receiving end, but for some of you, you could be on the giving end as well. So this person here, be that you or them, is preparing themselves to come forward and make a proposal to someone. The proposal doesn't have to be ultimate proposal where you are, you know, asking this person to marry you or something. It can be just that, you know, okay, fine, look, I have this to offer in a connection. Are you willing to give in to the connection? Yes or no. So it can be that as well, but it can be a marriage proposal for some of you as well. But yes, I feel like, you know, it's somebody from the past for sure. So maybe you are on the receiving end, and you might be coming, you might be having a past person come in to propose you about, you know, how they see the connection going forward, how they expect this connection to flourish in future. So they will be coming in unexpectedly. Maybe you are not going to be expecting them to reach out, and this person is reaching out to you in the very first half of the week is what I'm picking up. This person is a past person. This person is coming back to you because they are madly in love with you. They enjoy being with you. They are somebody who doesn't you know, express much, but they will be coming forward and expressing their intention to be with you again, to have a connection, another chance, and to be with you, because they somehow feel very connected to you on a deeper level, which they never feel for anybody else. So I feel like, you know, this person is definitely planning, especially the first 2 days of the week, 15th and 16th. Maybe you would be receiving some sort of communication from this person after the 17th as well. But yes, for, you know, it's going to come in the first half of the week is what I'm picking up. This person will be already talking to you through telepathic messages. You might be seeing their name, you might be seeing their, you know, phone number elsewhere. You might be seeing the same car as they do have. You might be, you know, when you play a music, you would feel that this person is talking to you through music as well. So there will be some sort of telepathic communication already coming in from this person, but this person will be having a 3D, you know, communication coming in as well with you. As you enter into the week time, the first half of the week, you will be getting something magically unbelievable coming from this person. Now, like I said, for some of you, this person could be coming in to propose you for marriage. For others of you, this person might come in to give you clarity around how they want to go forward with you in this connection. Because this person doesn't find it happy, you know, they don't find themselves to be happy without you. They really like you, they really love being with you, but then this person has some sort of you know, you do add a lot of motivation in their life, you do add a lot of positivity in their life, and really want you to be in their life. They want to be, you know, around you, or they want you to be around them. So there is a strong sense of you know, this person is going to let you know that this is what they are intending. They want to be with you, but maybe for some of you, they are not going to be ready to marry you as of now. But for some of you, yes, they might be ready to get married to you as well. But them coming towards you, them opening their heart up to you, them, you know, making a proposal to you is going to be something very unexpected. You might not be expecting this person to come forward. You might not be expecting this past person to come, you know, and propose you. But yes, they will be in this week time. They have been having, you know, sleepless nights over you, over the connection that they feel for you. And somehow they are gonna find the courage enough to come forward to you in this week time. So yeah, let's see what the color cards have to add. Let's see what two colors could be lucky for you for this week time. Mauve and yellow. Mauve color, the shade of purple could be lucky for you. Enjoy clear hearing. Number 43. Be open to receive the messages coming from your person. You might hear them whisper in your ears at night, especially at nighttime. You might hear their voice as well. You might see their flashes as well, out of nowhere. And that, again, is a sign that they are trying to communicate to you. And soon they will be communicating to you in the real world and the physical world as well. Yellow color could also be lucky for you in this week time. Purify your body, number 22. Yellow color, you could wear it in, you know, in clothing. You can also light some yellow candles if you want. Yellow candle will help you speed up your love life as well, and overall the other areas of your life as well. You can do that as well. So yeah, let's see more cards here. Let's see what else is coming up for you guys for this week time. Religious factors. Your love life is being influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. For some of you, I feel like you and this person have grown so much on an individual level. And plus, you do have a spiritual connection with each other. Like I said earlier, this person might be already connecting to you through telepathic messages and signs and, you know, those kind of things as well. This person and you could be very intuitive as well. So you might be like, you know, easily be, you know, it might be easy for you to tap into their energy, and it will be easy for them to tap into your energy and send messages to each other. You might be seeing this person in your dreams as well during this week time, which again could be a sign which is going to compel the two of you to come together by the heavens as well. So for some of you, there could be religious differences between the two of you as well. For others of you, it could be the, you know, cultural differences as well between the two of you. But yes, I feel like, you know, you and this person will be coming in very strong together. So yeah, let's see more cards. Let's see what else do we have coming up for you for this week time. Past lives. There could be a, you know, you could be, you know, you could be old souls. You know, you might have been married to each other in the past life as well. Release your past life karma. You are an old soul with deep wisdom. Healing your past lives will raise your vibrations. For some of you, you might have to clear some past old life karmas as well. And as you do so, you will be able to reconcile with each other and come together on a stronger level. So you and this person could have been on an on and off journey as well. But I feel like, you know, you will be ultimately coming back together after resolving the past karmic cycle that you might have started with this person. But I feel like, you know, your souls are already married to each other. That's why I'm picking up very strong here with this person. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this week time. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe, and share if you're willing to get a personal read. You can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till later, the next reading for you guys. Take care. Bye-bye.